Gaga.
Hey guys, here's the new review, and if you can't tell, don't want something Claptrap related. As you may or may not know, I like the Claptrap robot quite a bit. Never played Borderlands. Borderlands 1 and 2, never play them, and I know that's gonna sound blasphemous to a lot of you, and especially the fact that I'm buying the Borderlands toys. Why, oh god, why? I just really like the Claptrap design. I like robots. I like the way this guy looks. He just has a really nice design that appeals to me, and I'm a sucker for it. But I can understand that as they release more Claptraps, we have three now, and they're just repaints of the first one. I can understand some complaints about not wanting to buy any more, but I am happy to say that NECA has actually started adding things to it. This is not just a standard repaint. Yes, it is a repaint of the first one, but he does have newly sculpted bits, and I'm hoping this means we're going to get a lot more Claptraps with newly sculpted bits. Say that five times fast. But before I get to him, though, since I know some of you love it so much, there's a packaging. There's a packaging. Isn't that great? Here, you want to read his bio? You can read the life story of the gentleman caller Claptrap. I don't care. I don't. His accessories, of course, he does have the standard Claptrap base. Now, this is kind of a mixed bag. I do wish they would have different bases, at least sculpted differently. They are the exact same bases, not even repainted, just that. I wish there was something more involved, not just the standard base. Now, with that said, I understand that if they were to at least repaint them, give them different styles, it wouldn't look right. The way it is now, they have a nice, consistent look, and we've got to the point now where I don't really want to complain too much about the bases. If they had been doing repaints since day one, that would have been one thing. But the fact that we are now four figures in the same base, I think it's time to stop complaining. It is what it is. But he has more accessories. He's got two little, I want to call them sleeves. They're not. I want to call them collars. They're not collars. They're for your wrists. I'm uncultured swine. What can I say? But he gets those for his arms and a little monocle. So to get things started, all you do, first extend his antenna. He does need this. The first time you get him, if it's like mine, it may be extremely difficult to get his antenna extended all the way. You can see there is that little raised bit. Still, it's a challenge. There's so much paint kind of caked over the hole that it does make it kind of where it gets stuck. Just keep working at it. It will come out in time. For these little guys, all you do, they open up like this. They're not really locked in. There's nothing really pegging them in place. You just extend them outwards and then put those over his arms. Easy peasy. Just like that. And it's nice how these little tiny additions actually add so much newly sculpted bits to him. There's that on there. There's that. I think I put him on the right arms. I don't know if it really matters. But there you go. And of course you have the monocle. I do wish there was some kind of peg where this could actually lock in place. As it is, you just slide it in his hand and it's held in by friction. So you can give him his little monocle. And there you have your gentleman caller Claptrap, which from my understanding he really should be called the banker Claptrap. So I'm not entirely sure why he's called the gentleman caller Claptrap. I don't know. But there you go. Now, as you notice, he does have the same problem that they all do when you first get them. When you put Claptrap on his base, he kind of looks forward. There's no resistance to really keep him standing upright. Just his weight forces him to look down. I highly recommend, if you are buying any of the Claptraps, to give them springs. And that's what I've done with my other three. You can see this one stands upright. He still has the whole shocks and all the little hydraulic bits in there, but he's standing upright. All you do, get a mechanical pencil, take it apart, get the spring out of it, trim it to a proper length, and then take apart Claptrap's wheel. These two little bits where it connects to the wheel are on ball joints, so you can work them out at a time. You can pull the whole thing out. They are just pegged in. Put the two little springs in there. It is a huge improvement, and it makes him actually stand upright. He can actually hold his own weight, and he's not constantly just going down on himself like that. But that's all that I can complain with this guy. That's just that one minor thing that I can understand why they didn't do it. Putting springs in this could be too challenging, could raise the price. I don't know. But as it is, add springs to it. He will look a whole lot better, at least on his stand. If you're going to be playing with it a lot, you may not consider it a big deal. There's that. So you can see this is the Gentleman Caller Claptrap. He does have a top hat that, as far as I know, cannot be removed. I've tugged on it. I've tried to get rid of it. It is on there very securely. He has a little mustache. And besides those new additions, he is the exact same as all the previous Claptraps. Those little flaps do fold up. The little eye flap is a bit hindered by his top hat, but it can still move. Articulation-wise for him, the arms can still rotate 360 degrees all the way around. They can swing out to the sides very nice and far and go above his head. He has an elbow joint that is very, very nice. It goes forward and it goes back. He's a robot. He don't care about that kind of stuff. It can rotate above the elbow. I do wish, at least for this one, there was an added wrist joint where you could rotate his wrist. Because as it is, you can't really get him holding the monocle over his eye. Maybe that never happened in the game, but I would have liked if he could have had the monocle over his eye. Just, it's a minor thing, I guess. He does, of course, still have the tray that opens up. If I can get my fingernails in there. There you go. He, of course, has the little tray. The wheel spins freely. There are little shock absorbers in there. And, of course, his eye can look all the way around. Once you get it going, it is in there very, very securely. It isn't a ball joint, so you can have it going in a nice variety of positions. And that's a very, very minor detail that they didn't have to include, but I'm glad that they did, because it does add a lot more personality to the toy, having look in a variety of directions. And that's really it. One thing that I do find kind of interesting, this guy has the same detail as all the others. He has all this little painted in bits there, detail on his wheels, all that stuff there, but the detail pops a lot more with this guy, and I'm trying to figure out why that is. Maybe it's because he doesn't have as much of that overall worn look. He looks like he's been in a bank all day. He doesn't look like he's been out in the wasteland. So maybe that's why things look a bit shinier. I honestly don't know. Like, these bits especially, they stand out a lot more. I even went, oh wow, new painted detail, but those are on the others. So I don't know. Those actually just stand out a lot more on this guy. And I am very, very glad that NECA are actually doing Claptraps that are, not just a repaint. There's actually newly sculpted bits. There's retooling involved, all that kind of stuff. And that's all that I can say for these guys. In terms of my favorites, I think detail-wise, I still like the Jacobs Claptrap the most. The overall design works a lot more, just the intricate paint jobs on them. But the Gentleman Caller, I think, is a very, very worthy addition to your collection. It's nice to have a Claptrap that is not just this guy with a new paint job. If you're like me and you like buying these guys, EntertainmentEarth.com has them for $19. $19, I think, is a worthy price for this thing. They are decently scaled, and they will look very, very nice, whether it is your video game collection, your Borderlands collection, or just your robots collection. I love these guys, and I would say pick them up. That is all that I can say for this video. I hope you have enjoyed it. Hope you have a great April Fool's Day. Go pull some pranks that no one will see coming, because it's not like anybody uses this day to prank others. You'll be original. I promise. But anyway, thanks for watching as always, guys, and I will see you around. Take care.